Welcome children, today's lesson is momentum. What is momentum? Momentum is how difficult to stop a moving object. Then we'll see one of your friend throwing a pencil to you. You can catch it easy. Then a putt, throwing a putt. You can't catch it easily, right? Then the putt is handed over, you can take it, right? Here, heavy is, the pencil is less. This has large heavy, then we can't catch the putt. Then it handed over, we can easily take it. Why? In their throwing, there is some velocity. If it is handed over, no velocity. Right? Then a bullet. A bullet fired from a gun. Right? It is a small mass. Bullet is a small mass. But we can't stop the bullet. Why? It has velocity. It is dangerous. Stop is dangerous. Right? But it is, it has high momentum. Why? This bullet has high velocity. Mass is low, but velocity is high. Right? According to this example, you can consider momentum. Momentum depends on two factors. What is that? Mass and velocity. Mass and velocity. Then the momentum is multiplication of mass and velocity. Right? Then the mass is low, momentum also low. Velocity is decrease, momentum also decrease. Velocity is increase, momentum increase. Right? There are two factors, mass and velocity. Right? The symbols of momentum is, see here, momentum. Symbol of the momentum is simple P, mass M, and velocity B. Right? What is the units of momentum? Momentum, M. M is kilogram. Velocity V is ms minus 1. That's the units of momentum is kilogram for meter for second, kg ms minus 1, right? That is the momentum. Then water because there is velocity. You know, velocity is vector, that for momentum also vector. Then we consider motor vehicle. Then it's moving one speed. The momentum is high. Then its velocity is decrease. Momentum is decrease. Right? Velocity is increase. Momentum also increase. Then other part is mass and weight. Mass and weight. What is mass? Here is an object. What is mass? The amount of matters. Amount of matters. That is mass. What is weight? Here it's an object. Weight. Weight is a force. Why weight is a force? Here the object attached toward the earth. Force attached into the object is gravitational attraction. Here force acting on this object, it is gravitational attraction. Amount of matter. This is matters and the force, gravitational force. That is the weight, right? According to the Newton's second law, you know this equation, F equal m a. If the object moving under gravity, it is, we use F equal m g. Why? The here is normal acceleration. The object moving under gravity, it is g, gravitational acceleration. Weight equal mass and gravitational acceleration. Right? We can only say weight equal mass and acceleration, right? Right. The unit of this F equal mass is kg. You can write acceleration is ms minus 2, that is equal Newton. Right? And mass, you know, international units of mass is kilogram. The weight, international units of weight is Newton. Weight, Newton. Right? In the sea level, the G is gravitational force. Gravitational acceleration is, you know, 9.8 ms minus 2. We normally use, this is 10 ms minus 2, right, in the sea level, right. When they increase the highest of the range, the gravitational force is decrease in the mountain area. We goes to the up, gravitational force is decrease, right? Then we consider a mass of M. Consider a mass of M. M with this is mass of object is M. Weight is 9.8 m. Right? If we consider 1 kg, it is 9.8 ms minus 2. Right? Ms minus 2, this is going to come kg. Kg ms minus 2. Right? If the mass is 3 kg, that 3 multiplied with 9.8 ms minus 2. Right? Here, 29.4 kg ms minus 2. Right? Then here is the mass and weight. Then you know on the moon the gravitational acceleration is about 1/6 of that on the Earth. Gravitational force of moon is less than the Earth, right? That's the end of that your fourth lesson, Newton's laws of motion. We'll see next time with other lesson.